to Monday. Foggy, wet weekend. Foggy, wet Monday here. It's alright, we've been up for a while watching this Euro here. 113 is key. We talked about it last week. We really thought this was going to break on Friday. It turned out to be a low energy day. What can we say? I mean, 113 is hugely important. And for us, sort of secretly, 112.90 is the number it needs to close below. Again, if you've been following us, this is the point. This was the Barron's cover by European stocks, 112.90. This was back in June 2016. This was a big trade for everyone in the market. Obviously, when we broke this, we went all the way up to 120, 125, never saw it again. We feel like we're in a similar situation here. Daily close below this level, we're going to head right back down to 109, and then maybe, you know, once we're down at 109, 110, it's just a matter of whether bad news comes in the Euro. And if it does, you know, if there's trouble in Italy or bullshit like that, it goes even further. We're not going to worry about what happens at 109 today. Today we're going to worry about how to manage through this 113. We see some bids right now at 05. I can't really see what's at the figure for the moment. Let me just recheck that and see what's going on. Yeah, looks like there's just a couple hundred euros between 05 and the figure. Once we get down below 10, I'll be able to see more clearly if there's any nitwits down there trying to protect something or just generally buy or trade delta. But gotta watch this closely now. Trading at 13, the low has been 09. Massively, massively important level. So let's get ready for this mentally. And see how we go. We have some European numbers tomorrow. I don't think we have any today. Let me just quick look the calendar. 12. Turkey balance of payments. Don't care. Bank of England talking. Don't care. No real interesting European numbers today. Tomorrow we're going to have some inflation numbers and some general economic data out of Europe. That'll be more important. So today this is going to have to go on its own. We see on this chart very clearly now we have this triple bottom. We have this massive pivot. I think this is going to be... well followed, shall we say. A lot of people are going to be trading this, so keep an eye on the price action. The price will tell you how powerful the break is. Remember on the 115s, we broke the figure and we went down to 60 quite quickly. If on this one we go down to 90 and then we start fucking around coming back to the figure, then you can kind of bet on the fact that we're going to probably squeeze higher back up to 25.30 and then maybe come back down again, and it's going to be one of those type of break trades. Then if we trade, you know, through 80, then it's more powerful, obviously. One thing we know for sure, it's never easy. So try and visualize what you want to happen and get ready for it. Quickly on the other stuff, dollars are... long. We had a bid in last night, 28.50 somehow didn't get given those. It's annoying. We're long. We like to, this to continue higher through sort of this 35 area and trade up to mid 40s, maybe up to 50 today. As we mentioned in Twitter at the open, you want to be able to trade this flexibly, have core longs, and use the volatility to your advantage every, almost every day. Dollars are does 1,000 points up and 1,000 points down. Sometimes it ends up right where it started, but this is the nature of the beast. You need to prepare for that. It trades very, very differently than say euro dollar or dollar yen or any of the normal pairs. So, core long dollars are looks okay. Cable got hammered. Brexit's fucked. I think last Monday Brexit was amazing. We are everything was in the all clear. This is how ridiculous, these Muppets getting out of the clown car. I don't know what to say. I wouldn't touch cable here. I have no idea whether Brexit's fucked or it's good or it's there's gonna be another vote. Anyway, we closed at 70. The gap fill will be prices towards 70. There was a huge volume that went through below 50. Obviously, there's going to be loads of stops there. Couldn't get back above that. Cable looks like shit. Brexit looks like shit. It's like, what is it? A shit show, as they say. Aussie and Kiwi have turned back lower again. Is this a big enough squeeze to take out some shorts? I don't know. But they've turned lower now. We don't have a dog in this fight here, so we're just focusing on euro and dollar ZAR today. They've turned. And dollar CAD should continue higher today. 132.30 is massively important in dollar CAD, so keep an eye on that. Crude smashed. 10 down days in a row, I was talking about it. We made a high up to 61.08 today, but crude looks pretty bad. Saudi's supposedly cutting supplies, but crude looks to be a sell in the 60s, 62, 63. That's it for me. Euro's just about to break 10 again, so I've got to start paying attention here. Good luck, people. Talk to you on Twitter and tomorrow.